Encircling the Pacific Ocean is a region that has intrigued explorers and scientists alike for centuries. The Ring of Fire. It's an area lined with nearly 500 volcanoes, and no two are quite alike. But what do you think causes all the fiery displays around this ring? Today, we'll be visiting a few spots around the Ring of Fire to find out. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to explain what causes volcanic eruptions, differentiate between the three types of volcanoes, and describe the ways volcanoes shape the Earth's surface. Let's get started! Our journey starts in the village of Paricutin, Mexico. One quiet day in 1943, the ground suddenly cracked open and began to spew ash. Within 24 hours, the ash had formed a mound 30 feet high. In just a week, it was 5 stories tall. And a year later, the Paricutin volcano stood at a height of over 1,000 feet. Paricutin is the first volcano we'll be taking a closer look at. But first, let's talk about what a volcano is. A volcano is a vent in the Earth's crust through which materials like magma, ash, and gases can escape from the mantle. Then, during a volcanic eruption, these materials explode onto the planet's surface. But what made Paricutin erupt that day? And why did it grow so quickly? What could have changed below the Earth's surface that triggered it? The main cause behind volcanic eruptions is the movement of tectonic plates. As they slowly shift, tectonic plates create gaps where magma can escape from the mantle. It collects in magma chambers beneath volcanoes, where the pressure starts to build. When the pressure from the magma is strong enough to burst through, it travels up a vent to the surface, and an eruption begins. Paricutin is an example of a cinder cone volcano. Cinder cones form when a volcanic eruption throws molten rock and ash into the air, which then falls near the vent. This material quickly builds up and forms a mound with steep sides and a crater at the top. Cinder cones like Paricutin don't usually have a very large connection to the mantle, so their magma chambers are smaller. Erupting empties most of their magma, and what's left often hardens into rock and seals the connections off, so they typically only erupt one time. Paricutin's sudden emergence is a testament to how quickly volcanoes can change the Earth's surface. Let's visit another spot on the Ring of Fire to see how else they've shaped our planet. In Washington State in the northwestern U.S., Mount St. Helens stands as a testament to the raw power of nature. In 1980, a huge eruption tore through it, blasting the peak off of the mountain and ripping over 200 square miles of forest out of the ground. Then the ash, lava, and gases it ejected raced down the slopes, burning away anything left. In all, the eruption lasted just a few hours, but it permanently changed a massive part of the Earth's surface. But unlike Paricutin, Mount St. Helens didn't just spring up out of nowhere. It's a composite volcano that has been around for a long, long time. The word composite means something built from multiple parts. So if cinder cone volcanoes are built from a single eruption, how do you think composite volcanoes form? Pause the video here and record your thinking in your guided notes. Composite volcanoes form over time from multiple eruptions that create layers of volcanic materials like ash, lava, and rocks. These layers are why composite volcanoes tend to be much bigger than cinder cones. Like all volcanoes, composite volcanoes erupt when pressure builds up in their magma chambers. But why do you think they erupt over and over when cinder cones only erupt once? Composite volcanoes tend to have much larger, deeper connections to magma in the mantle than cinder cones. So after they erupt, their magma chambers start to refill. Over time, the pressure builds up in them again, and then another eruption starts. The 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens showed just how explosive an eruption from a composite volcano can be. And as huge as it is, it's barely a hill next to the last volcano we're going to explore today. This is Mauna Loa, the largest volcano on Earth. It might look like a pretty normal hill from this distance, but this massive volcano stretches across the entire island of Hawaii. Its name actually means Long Mountain in Hawaiian. It only reaches 13,000 feet above sea level, but the base of Mauna Loa begins on the ocean floor, putting its full height at over 30,000 feet. But why does it tower over the other volcanoes in the Ring of Fire? Mauna Loa is a shield volcano. Shield volcanoes get their name from their broad shape. They also form in a different way from cinder cones and composite volcanoes. They often form over a hot spot, which is a point where a steady current of heat rises from the mantle and melts a portion of the crust. The magma that comes from these hot spots is very thin and runny. That means it doesn't have to explode out of the volcano's vent. Instead, it can gently pour out, then flow down the sides of the volcano. And because of their hot spots, shield volcanoes have large, deep connections to the mantle, so they erupt over and over again. Mauna Loa is so massive because it has erupted about every 5 years, growing a bit bigger each time. It's so large that it makes up over half of the entire island of Hawaii, and the rest of the island is made up of four other shield volcanoes all joined together. That means the eruptions of these shield volcanoes created an entire landmass on our planet. In fact, all of the Hawaiian islands, along with countless other islands around the Ring of Fire, were formed by volcanoes. But why is the Ring of Fire such a hot spot for volcanic activity? Think about what you learned about the causes of volcanic eruptions. Then pause here and record your thinking in your guided notes. The Ring of Fire traces the outline of the tectonic plate beneath the Pacific Ocean, and all the boundaries where it crashes into other plates. All this movement makes plenty of openings for magma to rise towards Earth's surface. Now, you might be thinking, what about Mauna Loa? It doesn't sit on the boundary, it's right in the middle of the plate. Well, remember the hot spot underneath it? The Pacific plate drifts, but the hot spot stays in one place. The movements of the plate cause the older islands to constantly shift, opening up space for new ones to form atop the hot spot. The awe-inspiring processes shaping our world around the Ring of Fire all come down to the movement of the Pacific plate. Now, let's recap what we've learned today on our journey around the Ring of Fire. Now you know that volcanic eruptions happen when pressure builds up in magma chambers from materials that were pushed to the surface by shifting tectonic plates. You also know that there are three kinds of volcanoes: cinder cone, composite, and shield, and that from creating new islands to leveling entire forests, every volcanic eruption can have huge impacts on our planet's surface. Be sure to check out the practice questions and activities that go with this lesson to learn even more about the forces churning deep within our planet. And remember, in earth science, as in life, you rock! See you next time!